Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another Tuesday, an edition of Ask Nick. That's right, you guys DM me your questions on Instagram. I answer them here every Tuesday, and I also give away a free pair of shoes. We're gonna do that at some point during this episode, but right now, we gotta talk about fires. I don't know if you've noticed, but the entire West Coast is on fire. And it's not just the evacuations that are causing distress, which they are causing a lot of problems, but also the smoke. The entire West Coast is covered in smoke. I'm gonna show you what it looks like right here in Eugene, Oregon. That's what we're dealing with right now. That is not fog. That would be an otherwise perfectly clear blue sky. But that is the smoke that we are dealing with. And it's freaking horrible. I'll tell you what, it's in the back of my throat. It's in my lungs. It just hurts, and it's been like this for a week. And naturally, that has a lot of people asking, is it okay to exercise in this? And I've done a lot of research on this because, one, I want to give you guys an informed answer, an informed opinion on this. But two, I want to go exercise. I hate this. I love running outside. I love biking outside. For those of you who are new to this channel and what I'm about, I'm a two-time Olympian in the sport of track and field, and I'm a fitness fanatic. And I feel like I can't even work out right now. Here's the question. Is there a safe way to run with all the ash in the air? Is wearing a face mask enough, or should I just wait until the air eventually clears up to get back out there? Great question. So timely for all of us on the West Coast, but I mean, fires happen all over the world, and what I've come to the conclusion of through personal experience and also through my research is that there are times when it's okay and there's times when it's not. So first of all, you need to recognize, what kind of person are you? Are you elderly? Do you have pre-existing conditions like asthma? Do you get shortness of breath quickly? If that's the case, you're going to need to look at the air quality index and be a lot more conservative. If you're young and healthy and don't have any of those pre-existing conditions, maybe you can be a little bit more aggressive. Now, I'm going to be referring a lot to what's called an air quality index. That's how we measure, you know, the air outside, whether it's pollution from cars or, in this case, pollution from wildfires. What we're going to be looking at is the air quality index. Now, I've pulled it up here. This is from the EPA, and you'll see it's measured into six different categories. 0 to 50 is good, it's green, and the worst category is kind of a maroon, it's hazardous. And we talk about this scale, 0 to whatever it ends up being, and it falls into different categories. You know, look at the green, for example. 0 to 50, air quality is satisfactory, and air pollution poses little or no risk. It's a great day to be outside. I miss these days. These were the days where I'm out hammering miles, I'm riding my bike, I'm probably spending all day outside. You know, and you go all the way to the far end of that, what 301 and higher looks like, and let me be clear, most of the West Coast is in the 400s and 500s. Health warning of emergency conditions, everyone is more likely to be affected. You know, and if I'm going to link to this in the description below so you can go through and read. But each level of significance has kind of a different recommendation on what you should be doing. Whether you're a sensitive person, like in the orange category, for example, 101 to 150, members of sensitive groups may experience health effects. The general public is less likely to be affected. Now, through my own experience, right now, what you just saw outside, it's 286 on this scale. That would put us in the very unhealthy health alert. The risk of health effects is increased for everyone. And I'm telling you, just standing out there, it hurts to breathe. You smell the smoke. The back of your throat gets really sore. I'm walking around like this. It's not helping a ton. You do not want to be out in it, let alone working out in it. Now, yesterday, my wife and I drove all the way out to the coast, Florence. It's about 90 minutes west. And we went out there, and the air quality was about 128. Now, that would put us on this scale in the orange. And I saw people jogging. I didn't feel like I wanted to jog in it, but I did go for a long walk on the beach, and it didn't bother me that much. So for me personally, if the weather is in the green or the yellow, good to moderate, I will work out in it. Obviously, green's the best, and yellow, I have done workouts before. If you go to my main channel, Nick Sims, you can actually see me do 8x1K in a smoky air that would be considered moderate, and it was okay. Not great, but okay. Now, you get into this orange, and it really starts to affect you. I have done workouts, and I have run in the orange, And the last time I did, I actually broke out in this massive rash all over my body. I had a really bad cough for a week, and my body just rejected whatever was happening to it with regards to the smoke. So my personal limits as a 36-year-old man without any pre-existing conditions is I won't work out outside in the orange. It's just, I know what it does to my body, and it's not pleasant. Anything beyond that, red, purple, maroon, I am not going outside. I'm not even standing outside. When I go out, I wear an N95 mask. You probably heard about these a lot from the pandemic that's been raging around us. I do have some N95 masks, and those are supposed to help filter out particulates, so dust and ash, it'll filter that out, but they don't filter out gas and vapors that could be harmful. So if I have to go outside and the weather's that bad, I will wear an N95 mask, but I am not working out with that mask on. That's a much bigger question of whether you should work out with a mask on or off in this crazy world that is 2020. I'm gonna get into depth in that in my main channel, Nick Simmons. If you haven't followed me there, I'll link that right here. Let me say this. If it's bad enough that you're smelling smoke, if it's bad enough that you step outside and you have a scratch, it's not worth working out. And I'm a guy who says no excuses. So go into a gym. If a gym has a great HVAC system, that filter, that's gonna scrub out the air. It should be considerably better. But here, where the air quality index is over 500, even our gyms are closed. So as frustrating as it's been, I haven't been able to do much. I'm doing some at-home workouts right now. And as soon as I can on the weekends, I escape out to the coast where the air is a little bit better. Find out what works for you. Running with a mask is not going to be helpful. It may filter out some of the ash, but it's still going to be really harmful on your lungs if you're running in the very unhealthy, the unhealthier, the hazardous air. So take a break. Every once in a while, it's okay to do that. If you live on the West Coast and you're stuck in hazardous air right now, and you don't have access to a gym, it is okay to take a break occasionally. Something I like to tell young athletes, be the kind of athlete that can roll with the punches. And 2020 has thrown us a lot of punches, but I want you guys to be the kind of athletes that say, okay, well, if I can't run outside, I'll run inside. Oh, if I can't run inside, I'll do core inside. And I do have some videos up on core and at-home bodyweight workouts on my main channel. I want you guys to be the kind of athletes that don't fixate on problems and don't allow stress and anxiety to creep into your lives. I want you to be the kind of athletes that roll with the punches. The air will clear out again. We will be outside working out again very, very soon. And taking a day or 2 days or even a week or two off is not the end of the world. We will get through this. What could help us get through this is maybe a little shoe shopping, right? What a great time to get online and look at some shoes and maybe find out what the best shoe model is for you. Now, when I buy my shoes, you know I buy them from Running Warehouse. I'll actually link them down in the description below. For men's and women's shoes, they have the best selection at great deals, and I've partnered with them to give away a pair of shoes every single week. I do this right here on YouTube at Nick Simmons 2. I announce the winners. But if you want a chance to win a pair of shoes, all you gotta do is follow me on Instagram at Nick Simmons. And today's winner, I'm gonna mess up his name, but it's chosen at random. It's Griffin Lissick. Griffin, you're the man. Thank you for following me. I appreciate all of my followers. I absolutely love giving back to this community, and I try to do that with these videos that I hope you find somewhat informative. If you do, hit that subscribe button, and every single Tuesday on Nick Simmons 2, I will be giving away a new pair of shoes. So I'll see you guys next week.